edge of the Institute's property. It was built to store plutonium for an atomic power project they did here a few years ago.
And there's a vault there.
Oh, you better believe it. The walls are made of lead, then steel, then concrete, 4 feet thick. So if our friend does come back, he'll never get out of there.
Well, that sounds like just what the doctor ordered.
Oh, dear, what about this place? If anyone should see this.
That's easy.
We arrange for an accidental radiation spill.
Oh, good. Just enough contamination to close the place down for a while.
You got it.
Ah, we need some more EEG paper.
I'll get it. Ah.
Good evening.
How'd you like to find yourself arrested?
Good idea. Call the cops. I'm dying to hear you explain that.
It's a pressurization test, Mr. McGee. It exploded.
I don't buy it. I heard you talking about your friend coming back. He didn't sound too thrilled about it. Now admit it, Doctor. You know something about that big hulking creature that's been attacking people, don't you?
No.
Doctor, now don't play games. You want to explain that big wet footprint to me?
It's a water spill.
Oh, really? What happened to that culture of bacteria you said had?
Fortunately for you, we took it back to the main lab.
What a coincidence.
Yes, wasn't it? Will you excuse us, Mr. McGee?
This institute is private
Doctor,
property.
If you know anything about this creature, it is your duty to report that to the police.
You're letting your imagination run away with you now. I have never seen this creature that you're talking about.
Forgive me, Doctor, but I am calling you a liar.
Mr. McGee! Mr. McGee, don't make me angry. You wouldn't like me when I'm angry.
Thank you. God, my poor David. Who will take care of you now? It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. I don't know if you can understand me. But I want you to know something. Dear David, I have loved you for such a very long time. Will.